If you are new to this channel, my name is Dr. Randy Morris, and I am a U.S. board-certified physician expert in infertility. I take complicated scientific studies and break them down to give you fact-driven tips on how to improve your chances to become pregnant. Before starting fertility treatment, any good fertility doctor will have you and your partner complete some basic testing. This will include a test to look at sperm. This is known as a semen analysis. Based on the results of a semen analysis, your doctor will determine if you can attempt pregnancy using techniques like IUI or IVF. How do we get to this point? Human sperm are pretty small, about 1/600th of an inch. That is too small to see without the help of a microscope. The very first microscope in 1590 was not even powerful enough to see sperm. It wasn't until 1677 that a medical student named Johann Hamm became the first person to see sperm. He called them animalculus spermaticus. He was able to see that sperm had heads and tails and that they were capable of moving. This was the very first semen analysis. Since then, microscopes have improved a lot. By 1866, scientists started to get the idea that semen characteristics could correlate with male fertility. Specifically, scientists started to focus on the number of sperm, the movement of sperm, and their shape or appearance. The scientific term for evaluating the appearance of sperm is called morphology. Eventually, scientists started learning what a normal human sperm was supposed to look like and what abnormal sperm looked like. And basically, a sperm has three parts: a head, a neck, and a tail. Abnormal sperm sometimes had very large heads, small heads, or sometimes two heads. Necks could be bent. Tails could be long, short, or also doubled. Over the years, various studies have found some link between the amount of abnormal-looking sperm and male fertility. The basic idea is that if you see a man with a large percentage of abnormal sperm, then those men would have worse fertility. However, over time, the assessment of sperm became more strict. As scientists were focusing on smaller and smaller features, many sperm that would have been considered normal looking in the 1970s were considered abnormal by the late 1980s. As a result, the percentage of normal appearing sperm that indicated normal fertility became smaller and smaller. Using today's standard, a man would be considered to have normal fertility if at least 4% of the sperm looked normal. Men who have a low percentage of normal appearing sperm are said to have teratospermia. If 1 to 3% are normal, it is considered mild to moderate. If it's less than 1%, then we call it severe teratospermia. Many studies have examined the impact of sperm morphology on intrauterine insemination, IUI, success rates in couples. Some of these studies have shown lower IUI success rates when the normal sperm morphology was less than 4%. It was therefore recommended that these couples skip IUI and go straight to IVF. Some newer studies found that the IUI pregnancy rates were similar. One of the problems with all of these studies was that the morphology assessment was done using a different semen specimen than the actual specimen that was used for the IUI. This may be problematic, as there can be significant variation in semen parameters between samples. Recently, doctors performed a study looking at IUI success. This time, they performed a morphology assessment on the same semen specimen that was used for the IUI. They divided couples into three groups: normal, which had more than 4% normal appearing sperm; mild teratospermia with 1 to 3% normal sperm; and severe teratospermia, who had less than 1% normal sperm. Couples were allowed to do multiple IUI cycles. What did they find? There was no difference in the chance for pregnancy whether couples had a higher or lower percentage of normal appearing sperm. Even the most severely abnormal cases, those with less than 1% normal looking sperm, had a similar pregnancy rate as those diagnosed as normal. Our Infertility TV bottom line is this: in 2023, the best available evidence demonstrates no difference in the chance for pregnancy with IUI based on sperm morphology. Sperm morphology should not be used to determine which couples can attempt pregnancy with IUI. If your physician is saying you have to go directly to IVF based on your sperm morphology alone, It's time to get a second opinion. Infertility TV is your most trusted source for accurate information on infertility and miscarriage. If you are not a subscriber yet, hit the subscribe button right now. A new episode is released every week. Don't miss any episodes. You can also check us out on our website, ivf1.com, where you can become a patient.